guys. So let's learn Queen of Mean by Sarah Jeffrey. It's a nice track which pretty much has one chord progression throughout. However, the rhythm pattern and the intensity will change slightly. The entire song is on the key of G minor. G minor borrows the chords of the B flat major scale. B flat major has two flats, right? B flat and E flat. So I would suggest you to, perhaps if you're not sure of the chords yet of this scale, pause the video, write down the chords of B flat major, and then you'll be with me. So the B flat major scale or the G minor scale has basically B flat, E flat, and F as the major chords. But in this song, we don't have that many major chords. In fact, the B flat major chord is not there. So you have a prominence of the minor chord. And since it's on the G minor scale, you start on the G minor chord. So let's look at the chord progression of the entire song first. And just note that somewhere at the end of the song, after the build-up happens, we go to the next key, which is a semitone above B flat major or G minor, which is G sharp minor, one step higher. And there are no rules as such. They just sort of play the song one step higher. And that seems to be a very good way to add energy and additional excitement to the song, right? So let's get started with the chords of the song. So you have G minor, then you have E flat major, then you have F major, and then I'm showing you C minor. And I'm playing it in a very specific way from what I'm hearing in the original. It's not played for convenience. It's not G minor and then E flat, which is sort of very close. They're playing it G minor here, E flat there, F as CFA, and then C minor. You play G, C, E flat, and D. And I've written that here, just below the chord. So this is mainly for piano players. This is G minor, D, G, B. Then you have to come down to play E flat major, which is B flat, E, G. Then you go up again to do F major, which is C, F, A. Remember, this is still F major. The notes are just not traditionally played. It's just played in a more interesting way. So you go G minor, E flat major, F major, C minor. So the first time you play C minor, it's down below, as you can see here. So, and the second time you play, you go higher. And with every instance of C minor, you do the E flat and then slide to D. Well, not slide, just play it with another finger perhaps. Right, so let's look at the chords again. And the left hand plays the roots of the chords as always. Second bar. Where the C minor went high. And rhythmically, the pattern I'm following is what I've mentioned here. Every alternate chord, they play at the off beat or at the end. So this will be on, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So in a bar of 4 beats, this chord will be played for one count. Sorry, for at beat 1, this will be played at beat 2.5. Next bar 1, next bar 2 and. Right? So let's try and do that in rhythm. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So the D also comes in at the end. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. You can use this pretty much for the bridge, the verse, the intro. You can use it for like at least 70 to 80% of the song. However, in the chorus, perhaps you could get some excitement. So you can play the off beats in the left hand. Thank you. basically the roots of each chord, right? And two and three and four and one and two and three and four. And the chorus, you can just slam the chords on the beat, on the pulse. So it's pretty much the same pattern, right? So you could perhaps look at juggling it up with the mellow part, which is just at the hits, and the heavy part, which is at the chorus. Also make the chorus a little busier with some additional accents. So that adds more energy, and break it down in the verse. That's pretty much what you could do pretty much for the whole song until the scale change occurs, where I've written down the new chords, which is G sharp minor, E major, F sharp major and C sharp minor, right? Goes on and on. So the scale change, like I said in the beginning, happens at the end of the song. I would suggest to listen to the song a couple of times as well. So yeah, that's pretty much the track, Queen of Mean by Sarah Jeffrey. G minor going to G sharp minor at the end, and a nice chord pattern where you have the on beat and then the off beat. G minor, E flat major, F major and C minor. Those are pretty much your chords. And then you transpose that to the last chorus, which is G sharp minor, E major, F major and C sharp minor. And while you do that, just remember to have the dynamics. I've taught you guys two core rhythms, right? So follow both the rhythms as you see fit. When the song's building up, play the more busier rhythm. When the song is chilled out, play the chilled out rhythm. Right? So hope you guys have fun playing this song. Cheers.